Next, I would like to call upon on stage Ms. T.A.R.R. Tilakaratna. The topic of the research paper is an investigation of the relationship between psychological contract breach and counterproductive workplace behaviors.
Good afternoon, all of you. My topic is an investigation of the relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. This is the outline of my presentation, background, then a research problem. Objective is significance of the study, then I'm going to discuss methodology and findings, then discussion and the conclusion, finally limitations of my study. First I'm going to discuss the background, the introduction of my research. Anyhow, I'm not going to discuss in depth. This is psychological contract is simply some psychological contract is very important concept in the organizational context. Simply, psychological contract means unwritten agreement between the employee and employer. It's very important because psychological contract breach causes many facts and consequences. It gives many consequences. It reduces organizational commitments, citizenship, and increase counterproductive workplace behavior. Then I'm going to move to what is the counterproductive workplace behavior. It refers employee misbehave or and violate the organizational disciplines intentionally and try to harm its members' well-being. Then the empirical findings evidence shows that there's a significant relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. This is the research problem of my investigation. To investigate the relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior, I'm going to investigate whether any relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. These are the objectives of my research. Identify the relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior and explore the extent to which psychological contract breach caused for the counterproductive workplace behavior and examine whether international empirical evidence applicable or not in the Sri Lankan context. Then I'm going to discuss the significance of the study. The empirical findings shows that there's a significant relationship between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. And also, we can know the counterproductive workplace behavior cost to the organization. And normally in the Western countries there are many researchers for the psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. However, there's a scarcity of systematical studies examining the relationship between these two concepts in the Sri Lanka. Therefore, I think this is a very important study. This is the methodology. I conceptualize this framework based on the empirical studies findings. Target population of research was the active students in Faculty of Graduate Studies in University of Sri Jayawardenepura. Sample consists 10 active students reading in the Faculty of Graduate Studies in University of Sri Jayawardenepura. Anyhow, I have able to collected only 63 field questionnaire. Research was purely based on the primary data and a questionnaire. The questionnaire for the measure the fulfillment of the psychological contract based is modified standard questionnaire, which is originally developed by the Robinson and Morrison. It consists main six areas: benefits, pay, advancement, opportunities, the work itself, resource support, and good employment relationship. The Cambridge alpha coefficient is 0.952. Then I move to counterproductive workplace behavior inventory adopted by Chow et al. 2011 used to measure the counterproductive workplace behavior. Use mainly six categories to measure the employees' counterproductive workplace behavior engagement. Then I use quantitative method and use the correlation analysis and simple regression analysis to show the relationship. These are the findings of my study. Pearson correlation between psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior is 0.691. Then the regression equation and the regression analysis results. Then I move to discussion and the conclusion, or the correlation between this variable was 0.691, which is significance at 0.00 confidence level, and suggested that there is a strong positive relationship between the psychological contract breach and the counterproductive workplace behavior. Also, simple regression analysis also proved that a strong impact on the for the psychological contract breach caused to the counterproductive workplace behavior. Also, therefore, I would like to say empirical research findings prove that there is a significant relationship between psychological contract breach and counterproductive workplace behavior, and these findings also applicable to applicable to Sri Lankan context also. These are the limitations of my research. The research study bounded to student reading in the Faculty of Graduate Studies in University of Trichavardhanapura. It is better, in further researchers, you can go for the more sample. And the instrument, I used two instruments. Anyhow, instrument may have limitations. It is also one of maybe limitation in my study, and I use only questionnaire survey to collect data. Then it's better you can go for both qualitative and quantitative method for the further studies. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Tilakaratna. Dr. Geeta.
As far as your research, you followed the quantitative research methodology and you correctly identified the conceptual framework clear, and your conceptual framework is clear, and in terms of the instruments, you were pilot tested and examined the validity and reliability of your instruments. It's okay, and you analyze the data through correlation and simple regression. So okay, very good, and find that the two variables are correlated, and explain this percentage of the independent variable by this dependent variable. It's okay, and if you discuss your findings with previous literature, I think your paper might be better, right? You would only elaborate your findings, but you were not adequately discuss your findings with existing literature. If you discuss more about your findings, your paper might be very good. Right.
Dr. Padmini.
Yes, Abhisthira Ratna. Congratulations, you have done a very good job. I would say very short and sweet. The research thought and the presentation is concerned, it was very clear. But let me point out one small matter just for your concern. The thing is, actually, the available industrial culture in Sri Lanka is concerned. I think it's better if we can introduce very advanced or a model which include or collaborate with many other aspects. So the uniqueness of this research area is concerned, I think, as we as researchers, it's our responsibility. Thereby, I think you can come up with very unique and special comments which can or possible to generalize in the large context. So in that sense, I think you will incorporate some personal aspects of this workforce or any other controlling variable or mediation or moderation variables to see the Sri Lankan reality. So hopefully you have done a very good job. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, just one further comment. With your paper, you've shown that there's a relationship between psychological contract breaches and counterproductive work behaviours. I think the real benefit from the paper would come if you could say, what were the psychological contract breaches and what were the main counterproductive workplace behaviours that that you observed in your study? Because that would then give us an idea of, give an employer or a manager some guides as to how they can, you know, maintain that psychological contract and what the repercussions for it would be. But apart from that, very good. Thank you very much, Mr. Tilakaratna. Thank you.
Thank you.